Well, families and animals are being rescued from isolated homes in the Hunter region, where the flood disaster has just begun. Today, Premier Dominic Perrottet toured the area by helicopter before announcing people in 8 more LGAs would get financial assistance.
Here's something Sydney hasn't seen for a while. The sun. A stunning morning from the Hawkesbury to the coast. But the East Coast low has taken a bite out of our city's beauty, especially our beaches. Almost 30 metres of beach was lost between Narrabeen and Collaroy, the council working overtime to get it back into some order. The skate park at Maroubra was more a sand pit, while down at North Cronulla, 200 tonnes of sand has been trucked in, the ocean swallowing the entire beach.
Our public infrastructure has taken a battery.
The focus of the emergency remains the Hunter Valley.
I was saying earlier, a bit in terms of the gravity of this event up here, the worst I've seen in 20 years.
Absolutely. Look at this road cut off just here.
The Premier touring Maitland from the air, with the Hunter River peaking 10 centimetres below the major flood level.
At least you can see it's slowly coming down.
Yeah, it's receding.
But not before a scary night for locals. A dad, 2 teenage girls and their dogs brought to safety, as well as a kangaroo fished out of fast-moving water, tail first.
Maitland's a very resilient community. This is where the SES was born in 1955.
Disaster assistance payments are now available for 37 local government areas across New South Wales.
We are on track to have the wettest year on record. This graph is rainfall recorded at Observatory Hill in the city all the way back to 1859. Now, the yellow line is the highest ever rainfall. That was 1950. Now, have a look at the red line. That is 2022. And we are expecting above average rainfall for the rest of the year.
Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.